My name is Dylan Quinn. I'm a communications and new media student. And for me, this whole process started with photography and taking pictures. I always found that half of my pictures were full of graffiti, and I would always find myself in these places that were just covered in street art. And I began posting all my pictures on Instagram, and I noticed that more of my pictures that had graffiti in them did better. They had more likes. People responded well, and people started commenting on them, and people started adding me. I started having a following because of my pictures of people's tags, and then I started meeting people that did the tags. They would start contacting me through Instagram with direct messaging, and they wanted me to film them. And actually, the first person that contacted me about this was OJ3. And he was really the whole reason I got into what I'm doing today. He just was really down to meet up with me and make a movie of him doing a piece, and it all evolved from there. None of this would really be possible, I feel like, if it wasn't for OJ3. He really was the first person that contacted me, and just, I never really thought of doing anything with graffiti or doing anything more than just taking photos of it before him. I really wish I could have interviewed him for this video. He is actually in jail right now for graffiti-related charges, and that's really a bummer because he's a great artist, and he's done a lot of good things for street art, and is really well known in the graffiti community throughout Portland. And I wanted to showcase this video. It's the first video I ever made with him, and it's probably one of my favorite that I'm the most proud of. So enjoy. Oh, gotten in so much trouble for graffiti, I would say that graffiti has definitely been a positive influence on OJ. He has always showed me paintings and skateboards that he's painted that are like amazing, that like anybody could sell, put up in any art gallery. And a lot of them you can't even tell that it's graffiti. He's also done work with local businesses. I saw that he painted an entire trailer truck for Eddie's Roadside Graffiti Bar and Grill. And he did that all with tears, and they painted it all in graffiti and it came out great. And I think that really just goes to show that graffiti can be a positive and you can really make money doing something that you love.
I write Seak, and my first memories in graffiti are probably back in high school. Just was always into the art, never really tried it myself until I came across a buddy that I found out did. And just kind of went from there. First memories are at his house, just getting into black books and trying to figure out a name. Seeing it as a stepping stone, yeah, I kind of do.